Good morning, Panthers. I'm Jackson Harris.
And I'm Angel Mendoza. The clock is not necessarily ticking that fast today, but let's get started anyway.
Angel, have you been a little bored during quarantine?
Yeah, a little. I can't find anything good to watch right now.
Well, lucky for you, I talked to a few people about what they're watching during their time at home. Let's go take a look. While in quarantine, you may not be able to do your favorite activities, such as go to the beach or hang out with your friends. So, why not start a new TV series? I talked to a few people about some of their favorite TV shows you can stream right now.
The show Supernatural is about two brothers who find out that their dad is missing, and they have to go on a hunt, which is they basically go and they hunt monsters, and it's this entire show about them trying to find their dad and then them trying to save the world, like a whole bunch. The show was really interesting to me because every season ended in like a really like cliffhanger way, and they always found something new to do. I mean, there's always lore about monsters from like different cultures and stuff. If I could rate the show, I'd rate it a 9 out of 10 because some of the seasons are kind of duds, but other than that, really good show.
The Mandalorian is a show on Disney Plus, and it takes place in the Star Wars universe, and it's about a Mandalorian, which is the same type of thing as like Boba Fett from the earlier movies. And it's about him taking care of this creature that people know as Baby Yoda. The things that made me want to watch it more was the fact that like a lot of the episodes kind of left you uncertain on what was going to happen next. And you never really knew where it was going to take you. I liked the show because I'm a fan of Star Wars and I've always loved Boba Fett. And so to see a show about it was very cool. If I could rate this show, I'd rate it probably an 8 to 9 out of 10. There was one or two episodes that I thought were very, like they were good, but they didn't serve as much of a point, which is okay.
Well, Panthers, I hope this gave you some ideas on what to watch during your coronation. I'm Jackson Harris, reporting for PTV.
Looks like I gotta watch some Mandalorian now. That looks awesome.
It's definitely one of my favorite shows. If you're a senior, go follow NPSNRS 2020 to see where all your peers are going to college. If you'd like to be seen on there, DM them so they can share your future plans with everyone else. And now to Katelyn with Panther Window.
Hi, Panthers. I'm Katelyn Garcia, and I'm here to give an update on the Australian fires. Yeah, it seems like old news, but actually the fire continued all the way up into March. But as you all remember, the Australian fires started in the beginning of September of last year, 2019. The fires even got worse in early November, and by mid-January, there was at least some relief with some heavy rain. But even though there was a lot of rain, it came nowhere near to putting out the fires. And the drought and the high temperature just escalated the fires all over again in early February. And by mid-February, extreme heavy rain helped contain some of the fires and helped contain some of the fires in New South Wales. But the fires continued to other parts of Australia. By February the 15th, over 46 million acres were burned and 36 people have died and 2 more people have died in January. By February, over 1 billion animals have been killed and several endangered species are also facing the risk of total extinction. There was nearly 3,000 homes that were destroyed, and several thousand buildings were also destroyed. People were also putting together organizations and donating. By January 31st, there was about $157.7 million in donations. Now they're trying to rebuild houses and buildings. But in April, the fires have stopped, but they're still dealing with a lot of the smoke. That's also killing people, and they're dealing with a lot of the carbon dioxide in the air. It's an ongoing battle, but we're determined to get through this all together. Well, that's all I got today, Panthers, and back to the anchors.
Interested in aerospace and looking for a new club to join next year?
If so, you might want to go check out our Aerospace and Aviation Club. Take it away, Jack.
Air Traffic Control, this is Jack Muir with Panther TV. Today we're going to be checking out the Aerospace and Aviation Club and seeing what they're all about. Let's go check it out.
The Aerospace and Aviation Club is a club where we talk about different things that have to do with space as well as planes, so on, such as meteorology, how to become a pilot, as well as different future technologies that could be coming out.
The Aviation and Aerospace Club is a club designed for anyone at all that is interested in any facet of aviation, aerospace, or just frontiers in general. we are going over everything new in aviation, in space races, and even just general fun stuff.
Someday we may have a talk where we talk about how to get your private flying license, with the different steps you have to go through in order to do that, which actually there's lessons you could take over at Camarillo Airport. As well as on other days, we could have competitions where we give away a pizza. If you win a paper airplane contest, a literal circle won the competition. It wasn't even a plane. It was just like a circle that you just threw in the air and it just spun right across.
We even have one of those little drones that you kind of pass around with your friends. And we're thinking about doing a couple drone activities in the quad in the future.
Last year, we ended up going to NASA's Jet Propulsion Lab, and I loved it. Got to ask questions to a bunch of different NASA employees.
We are in a second space race, believe it or not. Not with the Soviets this time, and us being the Americans, but with the US government, SpaceX, Blue Origin, and a multitude of other companies that are working to get their men into space for space tourism, as well as to the moon and even Mars in the very near future.
This concludes our flight to see the Aerospace and Aviation Club. We'll now be making our landing back at the Panther TV studio. Reporting for PTV, this is Jack Muir.
Thank you, Jack, for that Out of This World segment. And just like that, that marks the end of yet another episode from home. Make sure to tune in on Friday for our next episode.
And as Mr. Grimes always says, stay safe, make good choices, and don't do dumb things. See you later, Panthers.